ABC Television presents Tony Hancock in...
Hancock's Half Hour.
In my hands here. Talk about wash day red. I'm a fool. I ought to wear some gloves. That's what they tell you to do. Let's have some of the old jelly on them tonight, then.
This is no job for an international playboy like me.
Whenever this gets in the gossip columns, Bobo Sigrist and I'll be finished. Not that we ever really started, but always fancied her, though. Oh, yeah.
Doing?
You great oaf. What's the point of me trying to keep this great place clean when you come up with your great clodhoppers all over the floor here? Just clean this. Just spend 2.5 hours on my hands and knees scrubbing this place out.
It's about time you did something about it. I'm ashamed to come in here.
Well, that's it. What a liberty. You only come round here when the police are watching your place. And you have the audacity, the temerity to complain about the amenities here.
Well, blimey, look at it. It's like the inside of a vacuum cleaner.
Well, of course, we're all familiar with the palatial surroundings you live in, aren't we? Scrap metal yard with a roof on it. What delights meet the eye when one forces open the door? The great piles of knocked-off lead awaiting the melting pot. Picturesque lengths of guttering leaning up against the wall. The resprayed bicycle frames hanging on the picture rail. Not forgetting the Empress Eugenie bathtub with the mattress in it. You talk about to me about cleanliness when you come in your boots at a state like that. You're uncouth, mate, you are. You're dead uncouth. I'm house proud, and don't you forget it. Oh, no, this place got so dirty. I cleaned it up about a year ago, and it's filthy again, huh?
Well, why don't you give it a rest?
I've got a couple of birds lined up tonight, one each. A couple of right little darlings they are. You must have seen them.
They sweep the platform down the underground station.
Come on, then. Get your Slim Jim on and listen up down to the Palais.
No, you know I can't stand dance halls. The French chore gets up me nerves. Besides, I've got too much to do here.
Well, hurry up and finish it. We've got to meet them under the balloons 10 o'clock.
Well, I'm going as fast as I can. It's too much for one man to do in one evening. By the time I got me feet up and the television set on, I'm up again for the national anthem. It would never occur to you to come round and give me a hand, would it?
No.
No, of course it wouldn't. Hard you are. No sympathy. Look at my hands here. Look at them.
What's the matter with them?
All the natural oils have gone out of them. Work-ravaged lumps of old leather they are. Look at them. Who would think that these once elegant money clutchers once caressed the bare backs of debutantes at the Café Royal, once fondled the delicate stems of hop glasses brim full of Yugoslavian Riesling. And look at them today, dead things hanging off the end of my arms.
Well, a couple of jars of cold cream, they'll be as good as new.
Nah, they've had it. Take it from me, they'll never hold a violin again, Sid. I'll never get the flight of the bumblebee out of these again.
Well, you need a change, boy. I mean, all work and no play makes Jack a right Toby.
Here, look, why don't we get a wiggle on, get down to the Palais? These birds are dying to meet you. I told them all about your cha-cha-cha.
Well, you had no right to.
Well, I mean, I tell you, if you'd only listen to me, you'll have a wonderful time. We got it made here, boy. These birds can't afford to be fussy. They're getting none of it. We got it home and dry.
You make everything sound so sordid, don't you? No romance in it as far as you're concerned, is there? The shy first meeting? The boyish flush as you introduce yourself? Embarrassed downward glance as your eyes first meet? The innocent tremulous smile as you ask her to dance? The hesitant words as you try to make conversation? And then the electric tingle of excitement as your hands accidentally touch over the top of your pineapple juice. There's none of that for you, is it?
half a tin of brilliantine on your ear and you're straight at it, that's you.
Well, I never was a chocolate and flowers man, you know that. Now, are you coming?
No, I've got too much to do. I've got to wash these curtains yet. Oh, that's marvellous. Oh, that's the finish. To put the election posters up there again, I suppose. Cloverton, I can't carry on. I'm the shadow of the man I was. I'm getting old. I need a little sunshine in my life now.
All right, now, don't upset yourself. If you can't handle the work, get a daily woman in.
Daily woman? I never thought of that.
Certainly. I mean, she'll take all the work off your hands. She'll do the housework and the cooking and leave you time to concentrate on your career, your sculpture, your painting, your poetry.
Well, sir, I've let that slide lately. You wouldn't believe me, but the last thing I sculpted was that big toadstool in the front garden. No, I tell a lie. I had to go at the Christmas pudding when it got hard, just to keep me happy. Made a goblin. It was horrible.
Do you really think I could get a woman to come in?
Certainly.
There's an office down the High Street specializes in continental mates. Oh. They get them over from the continent, you pay the fare, give them 3 nicker a week, and they're board and lodging.
£3 a week, and about 7 6 a day for the grub. That's 2 and 1, that's I could just about manage that. I'd be emancipated. Me tiredness peak'd be a thing of the past. I'll pop down there the first thing tomorrow morning. I don't know, they might not be so bad. Old Max Jaffa might have me back, I don't know.
There we are, Lady Plunkett. Leave everything to me and I'm sure you'll be very satisfied. There's a Spanish gardener, a Turkish butler, a French maid, a German cook and a white Russian chauffeur.
And an interpreter.
Oh, yes. I'll contact you as soon as they arrive. Good day, Lady Plunkett.
Good day.
You fixed up, dear?
Yes, thank you.
Oh, well, if you're not happy, just get in touch with me. If you don't mind a bit of scrubbing, there's a job going around my place. £3 a week.
How dare you!
What did I say?
Well, I don't know.
One of those proud Latins, I expect. Good morrow, gentle sir.
Yeah.
I'm Anthony Hancock, the well-known actor manager. I wish to employ some staff.
Oh, certainly, sir. How many do you require?
One.
Oh. Sit down. What sort of domestic help do you want? Cook, nanny, gardener?
Just a general sort of woman, you know, to look after the cooking and the housework, etc.
I see. Have you any preference regarding nationality?
No, as long as she's a big strapping wench, she won't flake out on me.
Yeah, what about a nice little... How about a nice French bit, about 22, you know? A bit of the old ooh-la-la, eh?
Oh, I see. That's the way the wind's blowing, is it? That's why you suggested it. Well, I'm not having anything like that in my house. I want a woman in to do the work, not to save you the expense of a continental holiday. I want the lady who knows her way around with a scrubbing brush, not a bit of the ooh-la-la, as you so quaintly put it.
Well, blimey, if you're going to get somebody, you might as well get a nice-looking bird. I mean, if you go in and buy a bottle of wine, you ask for the best vintage.
Yes, if you want somebody to pull a coal cart, you don't get a racehorse, do you? I want a nice bit of vintage 1910, big, with big muscles on her. I want to get rid of the fluff in the house, not add to it.
We have several Italian women wishing to come here.
Oh, well, that's fine. I'm very fond of Italian.
What about the language difficulties?
With me? Language difficulties? I'm multilingual. Yes, I speak in the old Italiano like a Venezuelan gondolier. I was there in the Italian campaign during the war. Oh, I chat it like a native. Uno, dos, tre, quattro, cinque, 6, 7, otto, 9, onzo, tilt, 12. I can keep it up all night. Mucci donati, prima, prima. Come stare, mi ultimati, mare, comare. Costa mare, come you, you want us to travel.
I can keep it. If you just fill in this form, I'll see what I can do for you.
Yeah. Well, I don't handle these mundane things. My man will fill in the form. It's like an artist, you see. Yes, I have to keep my mind clear. Well, I'll do you a favor. What about a couple of tickets for Hancock's half hour, then?
No, thank you.
And then, nationality, Italian. Duties, housework and cooking. Age.
Another dirty shirt. No, I'm not doing it. The woman can do that, not when she gets here.
We hope you enjoyed this preview.
To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.